play in our national pastime, but not permitted to play because of the NBPS US game. Socialist questioning the workings of capitalism, you were considered sort of brain dead.
Thank you. He wants this ball spread to do well so the Dodgers can do well. And if Robinson can do well, that's a good sign. And once Robinson never did his ability, once he started dancing down all first base, my goodness, every field went wild, and every eye was on him. His players accepted Robinson's crunching, but as he demonstrated his ability on the playing field, they simply realized he might lead them to a pennant.
While the Dodgers continued their progressive ways by adding colors like orange and vanilla, and Brooklyn's boys of summer found themselves in a 6 World Series during Jackie's 11 years. Each time the Dodgers faced the enemies, and in the process created one of baseball's most treasured rivalries, two teams joined forever in their excellence.
Of shortstops dueling in Ebbets Field, in the late afternoon shadows of Yankee Stadium, while we argued who was better, Rizzuto or Reese. Like choosing between two words with almost the same meaning, astounding or amazing, incandescent or luminous, Rizzuto or
speaks for itself.
He
Yankees come
out
with anybody.
Oh, you know who this guy is?
Yeah, it was Willie Mays from playing in the Negro League in Birmingham. I remember him.
You know who that guy is?
Yankees Red Sox were the last major league organizations from Detroit. They belatedly brought Pumpsy Green to Boston in 1959. The wait was costly. Like many other American League teams, Boston fell far behind the more aggressive National League, and the competitive damage would remain for years.
So when he played in Milwaukee and Atlanta, where the mound was his warning track, and the fences drooped, or seemed to, when he zinged a liner that never climbed higher than a horse's head. In the field, he moved slowly, or seemed to, what is the word now? Deliberately getting there. Was always the tortoise whipping the hare. Check the records for luck. You'll find the numbers were on his wrist.
Hall of Famer Hank Aaron.
We get it together in our life.
Kansas City was born. It was while barnstorming with the self-proclaimed New York Tigers that Buck first met some of the greatest Negro League players. His idol Oscar Charleston, Cool Papa Bell, Josh Gibson, and his eventual Monarchs teammate and friend, Satchel Paige. Buck O'Neill's name may not be listed among the greatest Negro League players, but he was a solid hitter, a fine first baseman. During his 14-year career with the Kansas City Monarchs, Buck reached pinnacles as a player and manager he had only dreamed of as a child before. In 1942, Buck was a member of the Negro League World Series Championship team. In 1940 and 1946, Buck won the Negro American League batting title. The 345 and 350 average. In 1946, Buck hit 333, two home runs, and one grand slam during a seventh-game World Series match with the Homestead Braves, but the Monarchs lost the seventh game. In 1948, Buck was only 36 years old when he first managed the Monarchs. All in all, Buck played in three East-West All-Star games and managed the West's component in four other All-Star games. As manager of the Monarchs, Buck's teams won four Negro League titles. World War II handed Buck one of the toughest trials in his life. After the 1943 season, Buck was drafted by the Navy and spent 3 years in the Navy. Buck was proud to serve his country. But during this time, Jackie Robinson had already come home to Kansas City. In October 1945, Jackie Robinson became the first Negro player to sign a major league contract. That event marked a new era for baseball, one that would eventually affect Buck and all other Negro League players.
It's your first time in my view to be a player in the past. I'll be talking to you about the way you heard Jackie Robinson. What did I say? I'm a motion. And Steven over Tank as a group. And
Marcy.